first thing that has to be done is to find a correct area for the target. Looking out for hazards. Including any aerial ones. A drifter is then put up to assess the correct placing for the target. The protective mats are then put out. The target is laid over the top of them, making sure it is central. It is then pinned down firmly, making sure the pins are pushed right into the ground. The pins for the 10-meter circle are then pinned out. This must be done accurately. The marking for this circle is then taken round. The pins are then again banged firmly into the ground. The windsock is then erected, along with the anemometer and table. The anemometer is also checked. The pad is placed accurately in the middle of the target. And checked. Along with the electronic display. And so to recap, the mattresses are set out, the target, the 10-meter circle, the windsock, the table and anemometer, and the electronic pad. The event judge, the wind speed monitor and recorder, 3 fichet judges, front and back strike. And from the competitor's view, the event judge, the wind speed monitor and recorder, three fichier judges, front and back strike. And from the ground view, this is how the target area looks. These judges are resting, however, normally they would be on one knee ready to mark. Other members of the team are the driver, the tensiometer reader, and the lookout. If, however, you have any problems, everything you need to know is in the judge's administrative rules and code of conduct. The next thing you are going to see is an example of a target attempt. The tensiometer reader calls and marks the highest tension. The wind speed monitor reads the wind speed continuously. The nominated judge calls finals and the judges prepare for the landing. The parachutist lands and the first point of impact is marked. The score is then broadcast three times and marked. The next flight you see is a complete miss. This scores 10 metres, which must be called. On the occasion of a miss, judges must remain impartial and quiet. Now let's recap on what you must remember. Wind speed on finals. Still and silent on finals approach. Use correct signals. Only one nominated caller. Do not discuss anything in front of a competitor. We are now going to look at the signals used. Left foot landing. Right foot landing. Both feet together. Fail to observe. And butt strike. We are now going to look at appeals. This can be one of the most difficult areas for any judge to deal with, and some of the commonest appeals that will occur are the following. Judge strike, wind, lack of height, out of the cone of possibility, and contentious landings. This competitor is about to make an appeal, and the procedure for this is as follows. He approaches the fichier judge, who asks him to report to the event judge. Note: none of the target judges enter into a discussion with the competitor. The event judge then carries out the correct procedure for appeals.
Here's an application. Take it away, fill it out, bring it back within 2 hours. You want £10 with you, with a £10, and it'll be sorted out. You won't give me a reason straight away. No. Okay. 2 hours. 2 hours.
Finally, here are some general safety tips for a good competition. 1. All equipment must be checked before use. 2. Continuous monitoring of the wind. 3. Continuous check for low-flying aircraft or UFOs. 4. An experienced and knowledgeable launch marshal must be employed. From a competitive point of view, this is how the flight takes place.
I've just got to find the DZ, mate.
Right, look at that.
When we get around there.
And if you're interested, this is how we managed to film the aerial shots.